हेलो फ्रेंड, वेलकम टू मरीन इंजीनियरिंग हब। दिस इज योर नरेटर रवि गुप्ता। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक, सीवेज ट्रीटमेंट प्लान। दिस टॉपिक इज टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कवर फ्रॉम बेसिक टू एडवांस लेवल। व्हाट एवर यू वांट टू नो अबाउट सीवेज विल बी कवर्ड इन दिस टॉपिक। द टॉपिक विल कवर द लेजिस्लेशन एंड रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशन ऑफ द सीवेज। After that, there is an introduction to which I am going to tell you how the sewage and why the sewage is treated. After that, the sketch diagram to show how it works. After that, the importance of aerobic bacteria, anaerobic bacteria, and how the blower is required and why it is required, and then the holding tank capacity, why importance and not. So everything will be covered. So please remain tuned till last. You will learn a lot today, I guarantee you. So let's begin the video. First question is asked that why a sewage treatment plant is required. The purpose of sewage treatment plant to treat the raw sewage, to break it down into a colorless liquid and disinfect before pumping out the sewage. So basically, we need a sewage treatment plant to ensuring, first thing, to break it the raw sewage. Second thing, to ensure the disposal which is going out at sea is a colorless liquid, and third is the it is disinfected. So that all thing is been carried out by sewage treatment plant. Now there are very rules and regulation through which we need to follow for discharging the sewage into the sea. The first rules is say discharge of sewage into the sea is prohibited except when the sewage has been comminuted and disinfected and the ship is 3 nautical miles from the nearest land. So basic one thing we need to take care, if we have a approved sewage treatment plan and if the sewage is been disinfected and it been comminuted, means it has been broken down into a colorless liquid, in that case only we can discharge sewage, but 3 nautical miles away from the nearest land. So that we need to confirm from the bridge. Now, second thing is that if the sewage is not comminuted and not disinfected, at that time we need to discharge it at 12 nautical miles away from the land. Oh, but suppose we don't have a sewage treatment plant, we only have a holding tank. In that case, sewage disposal is also allowed, but it is allowed at a deeper sea. Means if the sewage is not comminuted and not disinfected, we need to discharge it at moderate rate at 12 nautical miles away from the land. Okay, now let's see about third criteria. The sewage storage in the holding tank shall not be discharged instantaneously out at a moderate rate when the ship is en route at the speed not less than 4 knots. So first thing, what is that? It should be treated sewage should be discharged 4 nautical miles away from 3 nautical miles away from the land, but the ship should be en route and ship should have a speed not less than 4 nautical miles. And second thing is very important is here written is that the discharge should not be instantaneously, it should be at moderate rate. Means suppose in the holding tank, if we have just stored the sewage and we cannot pump it instantaneously, we have to store it for a small amount of time so that the disinfectant which has been added to the raw sewage, to the sewage, treated sewage, will work, and after that we can discharge it. Okay. Now the ship has in operation of the approved STP and the test result of a plant are stated in an international sewage prevention certificate. It means what? That the sewage treatment plants which is to be used on ship should be approved type, and if it is approved, it will be provided with the International Sewage Pollution Prevention Certificate, which will be valid for a period of 5 years from the date of implementation. So every 5 years after, the certificate need to be renewed. Now the fifth thing is that the effluent does not produce visible floating solid nor causes discoloration of the surrounding water. The fifth point is a very important point, that the treated sewage which is been discharged out at sea should not have a discharge which create visible floating solid nor causing any discoloration of the seawater or surrounding water. So it should be the discharge research that it does not causes any damage to the environment. That it mean to say. But apart from all these rules and regulation which has been implemented here, but there are certain countries and regulation which prevent, still prevent totally discharge of sewage in their water. Means though you are 3 nautical mile or 12 nautical mile away from the land, though you are en route, if you are in their region, you can't discharge. That regulations are such as Black Sea, Turkey, North Korea, LA. In that case, what we are do, we have to store the sewage when we are passing through this region or we are in that region. We have to store that sewage which is been in a tank which has been approved by the classification society, and we have to disinfect it continuously. And after that, once when we are out of the region and we are away from 12 nautical mile, we discharge it at a moderate rate. Now we come to the introduction part of the sewage treatment plant. It is generally considered that on high sea, the ocean are capable of dealing the raw sewage. Means basically, since from the ancient age, means human are disposing their sewage directly into the river water or in the seawater. Okay, but through natural bacteriation process, it is possible. But this can cause health hazard in the coastal area because bacteria and visual pollution, which is a major problem for coastal country with heavy sewing traffic. Basically, the raw sewage can be treated by the high in a high sea when discharged. But if the sewage is discharged with a regular rate in the sea, which is in a coastal area, it may cause pollution. Secondly, it may cause also infection regarding the water disease like cholera, hepatitis, like all that disease will get up. And second thing, if a coastal country with a heavy sea traffic, it may also causes some pandemic also. So to prevent all that, we must discharge sewage through a sewage treatment plant, and for that, sewage treatment plant is required in every ship. Okay, so let's see why sewage disposal is not allowed in coastal water. Raw sewage contain bacteria which affect marine life like fish, coral reef, etc. Okay, that point I missed out, that basically the bacteria which is present in the sewage can affect the fish, coral reef, and also affect the marine life. So that to prevent to have a healthy coral life, to have a healthy fishing, we need to discharge treated sewage. Untreated sewage on board produce gases like hydrogen sulfide, ammonia, methane. These gases are highly toxic and flammable as they are heavier than air. So very important point is this. Means the gases which are produced like hydrogen sulfide, ammonia, methane, these are also not only highly toxic gases, these are also flammable. So these have a chance, means both deadly and have a fire hazard. So these two things can produce if we are not treating the sewage properly. To eliminate this thing, we have to treat the sewage. Second thing, they may potentially create lethal pocket in an enclosed space. Therefore, we need to treat the sewage before pumping it out. So therefore, we need to treat the sewage properly before pumping it out, so that to ensure that there is no lethal enclosed space pocket. As you can see in this diagram here, my friend, that discoloration of the seawater has taken place because of the visible solid and untreated sewage. So the regulation has come for proper treatment to prevent marine life, coral life, and to prevent any toxic gas and flammable gas generation. Now here I present you the sewage treatment plant. So here now we are going to see part by part what are the component of the sewage treatment plant. So first, the sewage treatment plant is been divided into four parts. One is the primary chamber, second one is the aeration chamber, third one is the settling chamber, and fifth one is the chlorination tank collection chamber. Okay, now what is happening basically? The black water means the black water is a toilet water. The black water is coming means the toilet water is coming. The bathroom means water is coming, which is being used for sewage, is coming here, and the screen filter with a knife edge cut is provided, which will screen it and which will dissolve it in the primary chamber. From primary chamber, it will go and overflow and will go to the aeration chamber. In aeration chamber, why it is called aeration chamber? Because the in aeration chamber, the air is been injected through air blower so that to enhance the aerobic bacteria formation to disintegrate the sewage into very minute form, to have a minute form. For that, to enhance the aerobic formation, air is being given in the aeration chamber as well as in settling chamber through air blower. Means, as you can see, this piping through which the air is given here and here. Now, as you can see, this is the settling chamber. The sewage overflowing and getting the settling chamber will undergo aerobic bacteria formation, and some of the activated sludge which is having the aerobic bacteria will be bring back to sludge through sludge return line back to the aeration chamber to have further increased aerobic bacteria generation. Means basically this air blower is acting as a venturi which is sucking the activated sludge. Means what is activated sludge? Activated sludge is the sludge which is having a large amount of aerobic bacteria, and if this activated sludge is not being sucked out, in that case it will die out there and it will causes discoloration in the sewage. So this has a own importance. So whenever a surveyor will come, he will see that the sludge return line is functioning properly or not. It means that the activated sludge is continuously being pulled out and is pulled back into the aeration chamber. And from here, the air to venturi effect, the what air will take it out and will bring it back to the aeration chamber. Now, after the settling chamber, the total disintegration of the sewage is been carried out and discoloration is been carried out. Now, the disinfection of the sewage need to be carried out. That is been carried out once it overflow and will go to the here in the collection chamber through a chlorination pump. A small amount of doses of sodium chlorate is been implemented through chlorination pump drop by drop, which has been added. Sodium chloride is added so that the water, the sewage is getting, the treated sewage is getting disinfected, and after a small amount of been storage for a period of time, it is been discharged through a automatic operated level operated overboard pump to a overboard. Once it is ensured that it is 3 nautical mile away from the land and ship is en route. Now, one more thing I want to make sure to show you, that here as you can see, this sewage water is coming in the primary chamber, but the shower water which we are using for bathing, that water is coming directly into the chlorination chamber. Okay, why? Because this water doesn't have any bacteria or anything, so does only need disinfection. Okay, one more thing I want to tell you, that from time to time we need to make sure that the sewage treatment plant is been flushed with fresh water so that the cleanage means the sewage may get clean to the surface of the sewage treatment plant to prevent it get adhered to the wall of the sewage treatment plant. Fresh water is inlet is carried out to flush that cleanage and will be taken out by the overboard pump through here. Okay. So I hope you have understand the sewage treatment plant. Now let's move to the second operation, is that why the aerobic bacteria is causing and how it is breaking the apart. So let's see. First thing, the raw sewage from toilet enter the primary tank and then it goes to the aeration chamber where the air is supplied. The sewage is broken down in this chamber by aerobic bacteria by aerobic process. So as I have told you here, the sewage is been broken by the aerobic bacteria by aerobic process. So what is the aerobic process? Aerobic process is the process in which oxygen dissolved with the water. Oxygen dissolved with the water produce carbon dioxide, water and produce new bacteria by decomposing the sewage. So as you can see, this is a continuously regenerative process. So this question is very mainly asked that aerobic process is causing the disintegration of sewage and producing new bacteria and carbon dioxide, which will be eliminated and vented out, as you can see, through vent to the air. So each chamber has it a vent through which the air, the remaining carbon dioxide will be vented out. Okay, and what is aerobic bacteria? As you can see here, the wastewater is coming through air, it is changing into carbon dioxide, oxygen and new bacteria, which we are calling here activated sludge. Means this is activated sludge, what they are calling new bacteria. This new bacteria is returned back through this and again bring back in here so that the chamber is continued to give. Now let's see what are the importance of aerobic bacteria. It is consume oxygen dissolved in water. If sufficient oxygen is not present in water, a different family of bacteria is generated and become an anaerobic bacteria. So very important. Means why we are focusing on the blower? Means why blower is important? Because if blower is not there, in that case anaerobic bacteria formation will occur, which will have a different impact. What impact it will be? Let's see. An aerobic bacteria will produce a gas like hydrogen disulfide, ammonia, methane, etc. Also an anaerobic bacteria producing dark black water, which is not acceptable as it may cause discoloration of water, which is not acceptable for discharge. So mainly, as you can see, an aerobic bacteria is producing hydrogen disulfide, ammonia, methane. All these three components, as I have told you earlier, is toxic and flammable. Apart from that, it is also causing discoloration. How discoloration? As you have seen here in this diagram, this type of discoloration is occurring because of this anaerobic bacteria formation. So to ensure that the continuously aerobic bacteria formation, we have to provide air, and that air is been provided by a blower. So aerobic bacteria is very important, as you can see in this diagram. Now let's see why blower is required and how much amount of air is required. We will know now. So biological sewage treatment plant main aim is to produce aerobic bacteria. So mainly the thing which we are doing in sewage treatment plant is, first is that aerobic bacteria formation, second is that disinfection. That part only we are doing in the sewage treatment plant. That is the main motive of sewage treatment plant. So the aerobic part is been taken care by the airflow, which by, so what I've written here, biological sewage treatment plant main aim is to produce aerobic bacteria for continuous decomposition, for which continuous airflow is required. So for which continuous airflow is required, and that continuous airflow is been provided by a blower. But the blower which is providing air also need to be provided at specific pressure. Why? Let's see. High pressure air will not mix properly. Okay. If the air is provided around, suppose 1 bar to 3 bar, 4 bar, in that case, that air will not mix properly with the water, and that will not cause any decomposition, and again it will activate the anaerobic bacteria formation, and again same problem will occur. So high pressure air will not mix properly, as it will escape very fast without doing the work of decomposition. Okay, as I have told you, generally therefore the air pressure is kept around 0.3 to 0.5 bar. Therefore we are keeping the air pressure around 0.3 to 0.5 bar. Now after aeration chamber, this sewage goes to the settling chamber where activated sludge settle down and leave the clear effluent. So as I have told you, In the after the ASN chamber, it is going to a settling chamber where the activated sludge settle down and leave a clear effluent. That clear effluent is being flown out to the disinfectant tank, and after that the activated sludge is bring back to the ASN chamber. The same thing I have written here. As the sludge should not remain settled in the settling chamber for a long time, as there is no aerated water and sludge will become anaerobic, so settled sludge return to the ASN chamber where it mixes with incoming sludge and treatment process continue as I have told you. Now let's see the holding tank treatment. Now the clear effluent discharged from a settling tank must be disinfected to reduce the coliform bacteria to an acceptable limit. So basically, as we know that the sewage also contain coliform bacteria, and therefore we are carrying out the disinfection so that we can reduce the amount of coliform bacteria. How we are doing it? We are doing it by treating it with a chlorination pump having a disinfectant of sodium chloride or calcium hypochlorite. So let's see, this is done by treating the effluent by calcium or sodium hypochlorite disinfectant and colorless effluent collected in the last stage, and when the level come up, it is pumped out overboard by the pump. Okay, so I hope now you have understand how a sewage treatment plant different unit means like holding tank. What holding tank is doing? Holding tank is treating the sewage to reducing the chloriform bacteria. How they are doing? They are doing it by calcium and sodium hypochlorite disinfection. So now why blower is provided? Blower is provided, you know, now blower is provided for so that to ensure that the aerobic bacterial formation continuation is continued. So I hope you got a clear idea regarding each and every component of a sewage treatment plant, why it is provided, how it is provided, and how the sewage is gonna be disinfected and how the sewage is gonna be treated. Please friend, please do like and subscribe my channel, and please share if you like the video. I am making this video with a lot of hard work, so please give a little bit of encouragement to me by subscribing it. Thank you friend, have a good day. Thank you.